Most Blessed Master, bless.
Blessed is our God, always, now and ever, and unto ages. Ave. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the remission of sins of him who has departed this life in blessed memory, let us pray to the Lord. Servant of God, his beatitude, Metropolitan Theodosius, for his repose, tranquility, and blessed memory, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
that he will pardon him every transgression, whether voluntary or involuntary. Let us pray to the Lord. That he may stand uncondemned before the dread throne of the Lord of glory. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who sorrow and grieve, who await the consolation of Christ, let us pray to the Lord. That he will release him from all sickness, sorrow, and sighing, and settle him where the light of God's countenance shall visit. Let us pray to the Lord. That the Lord our God will establish his soul in a place of brightness, a place of refreshment and green pasture, a place of repose where all the righteous dwell. Let us pray to the Lord. That he may be numbered with those in the bosom of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Let us pray to the Lord. That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity. Let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Having entreated for him the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the remission of sins, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Thou art the resurrection and the life and the repose of thy servant, Metropolitan Theodosius, who is newly fallen asleep, O Christ our God. And unto thee do we ascribe glory, together with thy Father, who is without beginning, and thine all-holy good and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
In the eighth tone, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for the repose of the soul of the servant of God, His Beatitude Metropolitan Theodosius, newly departed this life, and that he may be pardoned all his sins, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy.
That the Lord God will establish his soul where the just repose.
Given life unto the world, do thou the same one give rest to the soul of thy departed servant, his Beatitude Metropolitan Theodosius, of the place of brightness, a place of refreshment, a place of correction, where all sickness, sorrow, and sighing fled away. Pardon every transgression which he has committed, whether by word or deed or thought. For thou art a good God and lovest mankind. For there is no man that liveth and sinneth not. For thou only art without sin, thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy word is true. For thou art the resurrection, and the life, and the repose of thy servant, his Beatitude, Metropolitan Theodosius, who has newly fallen asleep, O Christ our God. And unto thee do we set up glory together with thy Father, who is without beginning, in thy more holy, good, and life creating spirit, now and ever, and in the ages of ages.
Despise, do good to, O Lord, in thy good pleasure unto Zion, that the walls of Jerusalem may be builded up, then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifices of righteousness, with the oblation of the whole burnt offerings, then shall they offer whole ox upon thine altar.
For there is no man that liveth and sinneth not. Thou only art without sin. Thy righteousness is everlasting righteousness, and thy word is truth. For thou art the resurrection and the life, and the repose thy servant, the newly departed servant, his beatitude, Metropolitan Theodosius. O Christ our God, unto thee do we send up glory together with thy Father, who is everlasting, and thine all holy good and thy healing spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. give rest, O Lord, to the soul of thy servant, who has fallen asleep.
Give rest, O Lord, to the soul of thy servant, who has fallen asleep.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the
again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for the repose of the soul of the servant of God, his beatitude, Metropolitan Theodosius, newly departed this life, and that he may be pardoned all his sins, both voluntary and involuntary. Establish his soul where the just repose.
Lord, have mercy.
The mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the remission of his sins, let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and God.
God of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death and overthrown the devil and given life to thy world, do thou the same, Lord, give rest to the soul of thy newly departed servant, his beatitude, Metropolitan Theodosius, in a place of brightness, a place of refreshment, a place of repose, whence all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. Pardon every transgression which he has committed, whether by word or deed or thought, for thou art a good God and lovest mankind. For there is no man that liveth and sinneth not, for thou only art without sin. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy word is truth. For thou art the resurrection, the life, and the repose of thy servant, his beatitude, Metropolitan Theodosius, who is fallen asleep, O Christ our God. And unto thee do we send up glory, together with thy Father, who is from everlasting, and that all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Mercy on us, O God, according to thy great mercy. We pray thee, hearken and have mercy. Servant of God, his beatitude, Metropolitan Theodosius, depart in this life, that he may be pardoned all his sins, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord.
mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the remission of his sins, let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and God.
A refreshment, a place of repose, whence all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. Pardon every transgression which he has committed, whether by word or deed or thought. For thou art a good God and lovest mankind, for there is no man that liveth and sinneth not. For thou only art without sin, thy righteousness is everlasting righteousness, and thy word is truth. For thou art the resurrection and the life and the repose of thy newly departed servant, Metropolitan Theodosius, who has fallen asleep, O Christ our God, and unto thee we send up glory, together with thy Father, who is without beginning, and thine own holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Wisdom,
O Soli Theotokos, save us. Establish the soul of his newly departed servant, Metropolitan Theodosius, who has been taken from us in the mansions of the righteous. Give him rest in Abraham's bosom, and number him among the just, and have mercy on us, for as much as he is good, and lovest mankind.
Servant, his beatitude, Metropolitan Theodosius, and make his memory to be
Oh. departed servant of God, is the attitude of Metropolitan Theodosius of blessed memory. We offer these prayers in his home parish, the Church of St. John the Baptist, as a fitting place to bid farewell to one who was born and raised here, in the local neighborhood of Canonsburg, within the embrace of his pious earthly family, and the nurturing of the parish community, which has now gathered to commend his soul into the hands of our Lord Jesus Christ, just as they received him at the entrance into this earthly life in 1933. From his earliest days, Metropolitan Theodosius faithfully and consistently served Christ and the Holy Church, offering his talents on the highest levels of the ministry of administration in the Church. As hierodeacon, hieromonk, diocesan bishop, and most eminently as primate of the Orthodox Church in America for a quarter of a century, or half of her existence as an autocephalous church. Even when fulfilling the most exalted aspects of this sacred service, whether presiding at hierarchical and primatial liturgies, receiving the tomos of autocephaly, hosting heads of churches, or advising heads of state, Metropolitan Theodosius always remained an altar server at heart, that is, a humble servant of the gospel of Jesus Christ, as he had learned to be when he stood in the altar of this parish. In this, he most clearly offered all of us an image of the humility and meekness of the Lord. On behalf of the Holy Synod of Bishops of the Orthodox Church in America, I offer my sincere condolences to the rector of St. John the Baptist Church, Father John Katolik, together with Matushka Janine, and all the parishioners of St. John the Baptist. During the past several months, Father John has ministered to Metropolitan Theodosius and has also kept me and my office informed of developments with respect to his health. I am grateful to him and to all the members of the parish who have provided hospitality to Metropolitan Theodosius throughout his life and ministry, and especially in these later years. We also offer our gratitude to Archpriest Joseph Olenek, the long-serving and immediate past rector of this parish, and Matushka Anis for their many years of prayerful love and filial support for his beatitude. Both Father John and Father Joseph and now Father John have maintained a constant foundation of pastoral encouragement for Metropolitan Theodosius by keeping him well connected to the liturgical, sacramental, and communal life of St. John the Baptist, even under sometimes challenging circumstances. My special thanks go also to Protodeacon John and Myra Olenek, who greatly assisted in this task, faithfully serving and assisting Metropolitan Theodosius by taking care of both his spiritual and practical needs for these many years. Truly, their service is a great honor and testimony to the respect and honor Metropolitan Theodosius commanded of all of us. I'm grateful this evening for the presence and prayers of the members of the Holy Synod, His Eminence Archbishop Benjamin of San Francisco and the Diocese of the West, and His Eminence Archbishop Melchizedek, the local bishop here in Pittsburgh and the Diocese of Western Pennsylvania, who are here with us this evening, and along with other hierarchs and clergy over the next few days, will join in offering our thanks to God for the life and service of His Beatitude, Metropolitan Theodosius. May his soul rest in the bosom of Abraham, may he find peace in the land of the living, and may his memory be eternal.
Your Beatitude, Your Eminences, Reverend and Very Reverend, Fathers, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you for being here today and joining us in commending the soul of the newly departed servant of God, His Beatitude Metropolitan Theodosius, into the hands of that loving God. I would be lying if I didn't tell you that the past few days haven't been overwhelming, but I'm sure for each and every one of us, especially those of you who knew and loved His Beatitude far longer than I had the opportunity to do so, I'm sure all of us are so overwhelmed emotionally. But when we find ourselves in these situations where it seems like it's so overwhelmingly burdensome, we know that the grace of God seems to flow in even greater abundance. It is such a joy to have you all with me and us in this community here today. It is so wonderful to have a choir for once under Father Tom Soroka in the midst of a coronavirus outbreak where we so often seem to be singing with a small number of singers. Now, thank God, we have a wonderful, beautiful singing. It was just such a joy to hear that. And of course, we know that one of the ways we can show love in the midst of suffering and in the midst of sorrow is through hospitality, through real acts of kindness and receiving the stranger, receiving those from near and from far. So downstairs, we have a light reception planned. We ask, of course, that you keep your masks on as much as possible, that you maintain as much social distance as possible, but please join us. We have a wonderful little Lenten spread set up downstairs, and the same thing will be next tomorrow night. On Thursday night, there'll be some additional food then. So please join us downstairs. Once again, your Beatitude, thank you so much for coming to help us to sing forth His Beatitude, Metropolitan Theodosius, into the Kingdom of God. Thank you.